Has an entire chapter on in his book on being round. That's what happens when you talk shit to God. Neil says, if you look up Star Talk, Neil says, I have an entire chapter on being round. Neil, it's some of Roy's. He believes in God, ladies and gentlemen. He believes he is smarter than God. Neil deGrasse Tyson, it's some of Roy's. Stop! Neil, stop! It's some of Roy's.
That's what we call it. But not only that, it's slightly wider below the equator than above the equator. Chubbier. Yeah, chubby's a good word. It's like pear-shaped.
So my question to him would be, why is there land at the equator? Because water will move more readily than rock. So if the Earth is spinning, water will be collected at the equator. I mean, if you spin a wet tennis ball, the water shoots off at the equator, essentially. So all the water will be gathered around the equator. So why is there land at the equator? It doesn't make any sense. The other thing that's about the spinning Earth is looking at the stars. Now, directly above the axis of spin is the pole star, Polaris. Directly over the North Pole. And we're told that the reason that all the stars spin around the North Star is because the Earth is spinning at 1,000 miles an hour. Okay? Seems to make sense, because if you put a long exposure camera pointing at the North Star, you'll see the stars will make perfect circles around, perfect star trails. Pointing at the North Star, you'll see the stars will make perfect circles around, perfect star trails. The only problem is the Earth is also orbiting the Sun at 67,000 miles an hour. Okay? The Sun is moving, dragging the Earth and all the planets up that way or that way at 600,000 miles an hour. So why do we see perfect circles? Because that's the slowest speed that's...
And also, don't forget, those other stars are supposedly moving through space at the same rate of speed, if not faster. The universe is supposedly ever-expanding. All the galaxies are supposedly expanding away from each other.